Is trehalose an adaptation to the insect open circulatory system? To understand the dynamics of the insect circulatory system, let us compare it to vertebrate circulation using the human system as an example. Vertebrate animals have a complex closed circulatory system of veins filled with oxygen and nutrient-rich blood that is pumped under pressure to the peripheral tissues by a central heart. The blood volume of an average man is 4 to 5 liters, and at a stroke volume of 70 mL per beat and an average resting heart rate of 72 beats per minute, the entire blood volume of a human passes throughout the body and back to the heart in about 1 minute. In emergency situations, the heart rate increases, and oxygen and metabolites, such as glucose for energy, can be delivered to the muscles in a matter of seconds to meet accelerated energy demands. By comparison, insects with an open circulatory system must rely on blood mixing to deliver mobile energy sources to the muscles. Using a fly circulatory system as our model, we see the dorsal heart and aorta moving hemolymph from the posterior end of the insect to the head, where it begins to mix with the rest of the hemolymph in the hemocele, and flow back toward the posterior due to heartbeat, ventilatory expansion compression, and body movements. In active insects, rates of complete blood mixing have been measured at 25 to 35 minutes and for up to 1 to 2 hours in sedentary individuals such as dormant moth pupae. Since insects are highly active animals, and their flight muscles are one of the most energetically active tissues of any animal, the flight muscles must be able to quickly meet both sudden and sustained energy demands. In many species of highly active insects, carbohydrate is the energy source for the flight muscles. This may be one of the main reasons that trehalose has become the mobile sugar of choice. Here we see the internal structure of a flight muscle fiber, where trehalose is being hydrolyzed to glucose by a trehalase associated with the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Trehalose has the advantage of being a chemically inert molecule that is easily split into two usable glucose molecules by a single ubiquitous trehalase enzyme at its site of cellular use. The glucose then enters the common glycolytic pathway that leads to aerobic energy production. The advantage of trehalose as the mobile carbohydrate allows for high concentrations of sugar to be present in the hemolymph, without also having the chemical reducing activity associated with comparable levels of free glucose. And, importantly, trehalose has half the osmotic impact of free glucose. The next scene will explain the relationship of trehalose to hemolymph osmotic pressure and why this is so important.